Welcome back, everybody. This is more vintage story. It is map day. Let's tend to this stuff. There we go. We do have the orange leather and the pink, the purple leather. Also good. Look, one piece of purple leather, one piece of orange leather. I'm very happy with this. Let's quickly tidy up. Forget left hand things. We also want to get a what's it called? I want to get a weak tannin, two weak tannin. I want to get a bit more of the work done on the leather today. Diluted. There's soak tides, lovely, wonderful. Seven soak tides. We'll go ahead and get these processed through as well, I suppose. I don't recall how much. It said seven soak tides. There's eight diluted borax left there, so we'll need 40 tannin for it? No, 42. Oh, and I just threw that two tannin away. Oh my goodness. All right. Well, we need more weak tannin. Let's go ahead and process another batch of tannin. Pretty exciting day. We're going to get a map and see what our world is like. All right, that's there. The logs. Not there. Great. These are paired hide and leather. Yes. We'll get our leather bags as well before we do anything with our map. The heck was I just... Oh, yes, tannin. Need to stop and make some tannin, so let's do that. And then we'll put the leather in places where it belongs. That's the hide there. Here we go. Tannin, half of you. I'm all over the place today. I'm so excited. All right, there. And this one to make some more weak tannin. Awesome. Now, these prepared stuff there needs... this is scraped, which means it needs the weak tannin, and we don't have enough of it. We're making it there, so we'll leave this in here. We could make our bags for storage, and we can make our book. So our leather bags need eight apiece. I think that's worth using them up immediately for. So we've got four bags that each take have four slots in them. If I do this, one, two, three. Hold on. I might not want all of them. I might want a different bag. What if we took made a mining bag instead of the fourth leather bag? It might be a good idea. Or both, I suppose, we could do. These bags don't get reused. You know what? For, like, the leather bag is six slot. What is the mining bag? Mining bag is, it takes, it takes bronze and bronze. So I need two bronze plate and, no, we're not gonna do that right now. It holds 10, but it's only stone, iron, minerals, and metals. It also holds your mining tools. So it would have a pick and a prospecting pick, which we carry elsewhere, so we don't use up two of those slots. But yeah, no, I think we make another leather bag for now. Maybe future me uses the extra resources later to get a better one, but let's swap that out. We now have a ton of space. Look at that. Oh, 24 slots. That's pretty awesome. I'm going to say this bag... Oh, yes, this container over here. I close the door, please. That's a little noisy. I think we need to grab these guys. Put them on here. Boom, boom. We'll prep the sheet of metal. And we'll heat those up. We're going to bang them out into a copper plate. Oh, you know, yeah, well, we can make the copper plate. I don't think we can make the... We need more crystal quartz, don't we? I don't think we have clear quartz, I should say. We need one more clear quartz somehow. All right, so let's do the other thing of the day, which is to unlock our map. So we are going to make this and this. Now, the caveat is that we need to actually carry this book with us at all times. So that is the part of the planned cost Very anticlimactic. It didn't sound dramatic, but what it did is absolutely nothing in reality. We do, however, plan to use that to get the I don't know why I'm keeping these. To get the map. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up here. Where's our meds? Here? Yeah. I would like that much of those. We're going to go for a hunt. It is middle of the night. So let's do the map and reset. So, I forget what it is. / world config map true. Nope. help world config. Maybe it's world gen? No. Hold on. One moment, please. Okay, looks like we had a medium temporal storm approaching. The command is slash world config space allow map true. That's the first one. And then I also, of course, want the coordinates so we can use it decently well. And so we can actually, you know, have that little coordinate overlay. And then we'll do, yeah, world config allow coordinate HUD. True. There you go. We're going to need to reboot our world for this, so we'll leave and come right back in. Like that. How many hours are there? 26 hours, 14 minutes in this playthrough. So, we've been running 45 to 55 minutes, and so we're probably averaging 10 to 15 minutes of offline time per episode, mostly in large chunks. All right, we have that storm coming. Ow, high rift activity. Ow. Yeah, I got it. Sorry, ow. I was hard on the fingers. Let's go like this, and we'll do ingot. And oh, I need the hammer. That'd be helpful. I think we will put both ingots on. I don't know if that's a better way to do it, but we can do a heavy smashy smash. Alright, that's probably as far as we can spread it effectively like that. That's some very noisy critters outside. Very, very. Why are they always noisy when I'm doing this? You know, I think it's probably because they are always, they're always there because I'm always doing this sort of stuff at night. That's why they go crazy on me. And it is high rift activity at the moment, which is also not great. I'm doing this guy down here. You can come over here. You can go over here. And we'll drag you all down. Missed one. There. Oh, that was unanticipated boom. There you go. Why is it double hitting? That's weird. Just that block, maybe? I don't know. This is a task that the health hammer will do quite nicely. So we can put two ingots on and it'll turn them into a plate. Or we can put one ingot on and it'll turn it, or one bloom on, it'll turn it into an ingot. So, pretty awesome. But we can't do that yet, because of course we need one of those devices in order to do that with. There. And down here. Three extra pieces. Noisy fellows. Storm's not imminent yet, so we gotta be careful not to, like, oops and sleep our way through anything. Alright, there's the plate there. One beautiful copper plate. Oops. Let it cool off properly. Alright, I would like to get some extra clear crystal. This and this and... what is it? Lanterns. And the a single candle is what's needed for it. So are we, it's 2:40 in the morning. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pan a bit of material in the meantime. Let's say we take some stone that is apparently not. All right, there's chert sand here, we'll do that. Chert sand it is. All right, let's pan some chert sand for a moment while the storm approaches. I'll do this in fast forward mode and we'll be back with you in just a moment. Oh my gosh, hold on. What the heck was I thinking? Hold on. We have a map. Look in the top right. I have haven't bothered to even notice it. That's a gorgeous world. There she be. Oh, look at that. A whole swath of chert connecting here. And all of our previous prospects still exist. Haha. Excellent. There's the cassiterite that we mined. There's the hematite we mined. There's the not anything useful over there that we mined. I love it. Very noisy friends. A decent copper deposit out here, so we'll have to go for that dig deep for copper. 5-something there, 14-something there. Yeah. Decent cassiterite over here, and we mined cassiterite over there. This seems a little far. Wow. We really walked that far with those deposits? Jeepers. We've wandered, man. If this is that big forest to the south of us, where the honey, the bees are in there, and there's some quite diverse forest in there, lots of up and down. This is a little island. I said there was like some zinc on this wall over here. One of these clumps of dirt over here has a copper deposit. Another one over here that we've seen visibly. There's our flower bed for our honey. Oh, some of them aren't coloring in for something. And what is this? What is this here? Oh, that's our berries, yeah. And this is the garden. It's all frozen over. And what is in here? Oh, this is the cranberries, the blueberries underneath the tree. That is our chicken coop right here. Nice. There's our animal pens. I love it. Welcome to our world, everybody. So this is a big lake. Huh? What's up here? I've never been up there. It's all green, which means it probably is just like, I don't know, like is this a snatch of image from spawn time? That seems like that's what that is. Like we spawned here. I'm not sure why it's also like, oh, also that hasn't updated this part of the map. This is not visually updated to the white. That's weird. It'll sort itself out though. Yay, that's awesome. We have a map. Control V? Yeah, Control V can shut off on and off the, see what I mean? That's west. Can shut on and off the coordinate overlay, and F6 to shut off the map overlay. So that's exciting news. We don't have the imminent storm yet, but we'll go ahead and pan some stuff here and try to get ourselves a quartz. I don't know if there's likely to be a piece of quartz crystal in here, but worth looking anyways. Okay, well, we have the temporal storm imminent now. We've gotten through most of these, and we did indeed find another quartz, clear quartz crystal. So we should be able to make a lantern, so long as I can get to my beeswax and turn it into a candle. We can make ourselves a lantern. If we had gold or silver, we could make another plate of that to line it, which would increase the light effect of the place of the lantern, but we'll see. We're not going to get that today, but we also got ourselves a copper spearhead and some, well, 11 now copper nuggets. That's awesome. Flint spearhead as well. Let's get our character to bed. Off we go now. There we go. All right, so today's plan. Oh, we got another quartz crystal. Make that lantern, and that'll put us fully equipped for the season or for the expedition. Oops, yeah, get in there. Then we'll be real good and ready for an expedition. Are we off into the dark again? It's already just the start of nighttime, unfortunately. So let's finish this last piece. We need, come on, Pan, you silly. Ah, there you go. Sometimes it just gets stuck and doesn't register the right click again. Again, sometimes you just tap it instantly. I'm guessing that's some anti-bot cheat or just some bad code. I'm not sure. But it definitely doesn't register them all the time. So the lantern just needs the wax, and then we'll be good on that. We got lots of extra storage space. We should get some ladders. I'd like to go get some copper. But we can also look at design of a windmill. I think our first windmill is going to be... I've been digging little bits and pieces in between episodes. I think our first windmill should be over by the... over by the where the bread making is right now. I think that would be a reasonable spot for it. Oh, look at that. 20 copper. Good. We could make a plate if need be. I'm going to deposit this in there. This in there. Don't need them. And we'll keep the other ones. I have some more stone to put away. Lovely, and I think we will go ahead and make the spears out of these, at least if for nothing else than to just put them on the shelf. It's fine. Need the quartz crystal, don't need the clay with us. Where's the clay? Where's my clay? There it is. I need some more reeds, which I don't think we have indoors here. Seems like we don't. So yeah, if we're doing any spear work again, obviously we're going to want to use this copper spear with that set. Let's see what we can find for fun and carnage out here. Going to get things thrown at us, but there we go. We need some beeswax. It's back here. Now, how do we make candles? Candles are just 3 pieces of beeswax. All right. Lovely. Now, you can make them and attach them to a chandelier, which is awesome. It's got a light level of 24. The lantern itself has a light level of 18, which you'll notice right away is pretty darn bright compared to what we've got. So there we go. And oh, I didn't bring my copper plate. We should bring some travel food. 5 days left on this stuff, huh? 3 days on that. We'll go ahead and put those in storage. All right. Give me that. Boop. There's my lantern. Let's make that thing up. What is it there? Candle and quartz here and here. Nope. Quartz here and here. Yeah, there we go. Aha! We have a lantern. So it still gives us the same offhand issues. But if I switch from torch to candle, see the brightness difference? Substantial, and it spreads the brightness farther. So we now have no need for these, less need for these torches. So what I'm gonna do is just simply drop, put the torches on the walls like that. We don't have a steady supply of the quartz crystal. So hi. Ow. Oh my gosh, quite a storm. Get off my buckets. Listen. You're not invited to the party. Actually, you were. You invited yourself, but... See? Very, very rare breakage. I like it. We started with 45 before that battle. We have 42. Ooh, that's a little more than I wanted to be losing. Guys. Really? You had to be like that? You'll see when the end of this entire battle finishes. Where we're at for supplies. Oh god. Ah, that's terrible. Ugh. Jeez, that was just about death. So close. so close. You see our health bar? It's like under a decimal. We're dealing decimals there for oops, for a moment. Oof, okay. I love finally having this bow. Ah, temporal gear. Happy times. So many drifters. So much tasty grub. Getting me some more flax, guys. This is our winter supply of flax right here. Oh, I don't want them to get that close. See, that one broke. Definitely broke. We lost two there. Jeez, down to 38. That's unfortunate. I mean, it's worth the temporal gear and some flax, but... yeah. Troubling. Oi! For reals? You're just spawning in the ground? The heck, bro? I was standing there. I guess it's a surface drifter battle day. Jeepers, what time is it? It's only not even 8 o'clock at night. Another temporal gear. What? Epic. Very epic. It's spawning in the trees. Oh my goodness, lots of fiber. You guys, is the rift like right on top of the freaking hill? Must be. He was going in for the hit. Yeah, it's battle royale here today. Surface drifter. Attack mode. Jeez. Not hearing a rift. It must just be the night? Maybe. These guys have a relatively low drop rate, so... It's okay. It's enough that we get a chance to get some material. We got super lucky. It's like 0.2 or 2% chance. 2-point-something% chance of... they don't miss, do they? These buggers just don't miss those thrown tools. Where'd it go? I think I saw an arrow fling on past. Come on, boys. Come on out. I'm right here. Oh my gosh, dude, seriously. So hard on the medicinal herbs. How are we doing on the eggs? 2 days, 3 days. Needs brooding. Yeah, we are seriously low on the broody hens situation. I have to find some reeds. We have spare reeds. Good. There. Gonna get some attention doing that, but that's fine. Good. What did I just throw away? My knife? That's not good. A third temporal gear in one night! That's ridiculous! What the heck? Lucky McLuckster. It's the book, it's our lucky charm. Wow. Really, really fantastic. Oh, that just ended. Ended its timer. We got any more over here still? Nope. Like the swarm has concluded its attacks. Look at that. Three temporal storms in one day. Like, that's ridiculous. In one evening's battle. So freaking awesome. That is enough to unlock a... what's it called? The thing. The transport thing. The teleporter thing. Oh, you know what? We got bush meat that I forgot I was going to cook. I don't have... You have firewood. That'll do. Well, winter time, guys. Winter's on us, and we should probably have a look at our... probably have a look at... Seriously? Are we that hungry? Okay. Got it. I got it. Here, eat. Stick something in your face. All right. I will use one medical thing. Yeah, use two. Cheaper to heal with the medicine than it is to heal with the food, really. This time of year. Feels like it anyways. Let's light this up. Okay, I'm going to take one torch and leave it in here. The other one can be kept in here in case we need to light something up. You're going to make me some firewood out of these, which we can use to stack around here. Thank you. Okay, we'll gobble up the rest of this meat to fill ourselves up. 1, 2, and 3. Good. Okay, so we've got our book. We've got our map. We've got our lantern. We can actually walk with our lantern without using it to light the place up. I did a bunch of tree sharing in between episodes, so we have a good chunk of it. And you'll see if you... Oh, you might not have seen them in the dark, but there is a lot of tree work's been done. The shears were burned through pretty aggressively. We didn't even actually finish that bronze shear, so... But we did a lot of shearing. All right, and I think this is good. Look at all this. 17, 18, 19 slots open, plus our offhand. That's incredible. We are 4 days, 3 days almost, from having our first a barrel of rot ready. 21, huh? Lovely. Let's put the extra rot in there. We're at 45 of that now. We could start preserving some things, but the only thing we can really preserve is the fruit. Lasts for 15 days because it's so cold. So we'll start using up that food to eat or feed ourselves, I guess. Yeah, no, that's going to be rot, these ones. We don't have the stomach capacity for any more. Those ones are probably going to be rot as well. 15 days, 6 days, it's fine. The breads are good for forever. I'm going to go ahead and take a batch of... Well, you know what? They only last for 6 days in hand. That's fine. We'll use that because we're going to be low on bread eventually. We're good on our health. It is just about maxed out. 19.4, which is about as good as we can get it at this stage. Let's go have a look at the garden. That's going to need some TLC for a few... Oh, no. They didn't make it. These guys did. Okay. So... These crops did not make it. They're 50% yield and frozen. So they're... Oh, that one's done. That flax is finished. Good. Not done there. No, no. That one's done. 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 8 of 9. Darn it. Oh, I was hoping... Oh, look at all this. 8 of 9 flax. Not quite enough. But we've got enough to make what we needed. But we might need to use flax to make... repair our winter clothes, because I know we're going to need at least a bit of... Oh, that was not finished. Oops. The last one. One of them was 6. That one's also 6. That one's also 6. That one's done. All right. Not bad. The ice all over the place. It's awesome. Snow's starting to build up. Those guys made it to 4. Man, it's all right. 6, 7, 7. Hey, what's the temp right now? It's -4. Actually, these carrots... can progress, or whatever they are. Parsnips are -10. Flax is -5, which means they sort of could finish. I don't know that they would. Yeah, I don't know if this is spelt. I think spelt goes to... I think spelt is -10 as well. No, spelt is the warm one. Spelt's -1, isn't it? -5. All right, let's put these seeds away. We're not going to get more growing right now, but the rye can handle minus 12. The flax can handle minus 5. So if we had a greenhouse right now, it would functionally be 5 degrees warmer, which means we could extend probably most of the November in growth time. Whereas, right, as is, we're pretty much out of grow capacity. And these things aren't going to progress any further. Our berries are obviously all frozen down. The trees will not even grow taller over the season. Let's have a look and see what the animals have done. Still pregnant. I don't know. Maybe they need to keep eating in order to birth? Maybe. All right, let's see about fixing that. Let's give them carrots for the pigs. I don't mind if we use up a bunch of carrots. If we get the pigs growing, that would be awesome. Oh, oh, don't eat them. Okay. You had one bite. Yeah, I don't know if it absolutely has to have food, but let's go ahead and give them food anyways. We'll even give these ones some carrots. No, stop eating them, you dimwit. Just clicked in the wrong spot. All right, there we go. Enjoy, ladies. Okay, we got a lot of stuff there. We put our seeds out of the house, didn't we? Didn't we put our seeds outside somewhere? Our seeds, not our seeds, our grains. Where the heck did I put the grain? I forget. I'm sure we had an outside. Ah, over here, right. No, that's stones. Where the heck did I put the grains? They're not all inside, so... Where'd I put them? Did we put it all inside? Oh, I did. I forgot I put it inside. Which is not ideal. Well, no, 0.11. So it's really long. It's 9 years. Not that it's going to last that long because of temperatures, but... I'll put a bit of that in there, and then we'll go put the veggies away, and then... Then I think we need to go for a little bit of a journey. There and there. The onions can shuffle out of the way. Carrots take full dominance of this container. Another stack of carrots. Yeah. More parsnips and turnips. That's great. You go in there. You go in there. Actually, okay, so the onions can fit. Good. All right. So we'll take the meat and we'll take the bread. Have a little roast beef sandwich on the way. And a roast wolf sandwich on the way, I suppose. I think we've got enough flax in here now that we can prep to repair our gear. So, or partially repair some gear. Temperature-wise, I need it repaired. So, let's say we go... Oops, I didn't do that right. Right, that was awkward. Indeed, awkward. Can I place this, like, down here? I can. Good. Storage on the ground. It's lovely. I'm going to use this one up, actually. So, we could do the windmill. We could prep for the windmill, I suppose. But I also need a bunch of copper if I'm going to do... more chests and storage and stuff, but I think the windmill to grind the flour would actually be quite useful. And it would get us started with our first test windmill to see how much we're able to process. If we can get a health hammer going, that would be huge, even if it's slow and inefficient. I don't really care how efficient it is as long as it works. If it produces a thump thump on the anvil, it's working. We don't have enough hides and stuff. We will need to do another hunt. My reason for this linen was that we have this poncho, which is provides an extra 1 degree of thermal regulation for us, and the rest of them are in good shape. The poncho is not, so we need to use the flax on the poncho like this. Boop, and it jumps it up to 50%. It repairs it. So as long as the item is 50% or better, it has the full worth of its warmth. Now that's going to wear out as we go, but I can also pop in here so we don't lose any of its efficiency, and we can put one more piece of twine on there, and brings it up by 10%. So you gain a little. If you're gonna use, if you need 50%, use it as a linen, because four of those twine give you 10 apiece, and then if you make them into a linen, it gives you 50. So that's all right. I think the tailor class with their sewing kit can do better on the repairs, but well, that's our supplies for now. So the idea for the it's frozen. The idea is here as our, I want to turn this thing, this pile here, into our into our windmill, I think. Let's collapse some stuff off the back of this. I'm just gonna clean it all up and let it all bumble down to the bottom. And clean everything up for a some reasonable level here. Not bad. It is costing us extra food to be doing this with the lantern. So what I can do is, if I'm working, I can do like place the lantern down there, and that still gives us enough light to work with if we're close by to it. So that's, you know, sort of useful. We'll work our way up by collapsing it. That's intentional, but I guess I don't want to collapse there. Let's go up top and dig from above. Super safe process. I'm just going to take it right down to the stone, whatever that is. Let's try not to collapse too much down the front if we can avoid it. There, there's some solid stone. We're taking most of the height off, which is unfortunate, but we'll build the structure up around it. Probably some basalt, I can't use the gravel for anything, can I? We'll probably use the, well, we can use it for filler in waterways and stuff. I want some basalt blocks for this. Or maybe we do quartz for the tower. Oh, I kind of like that idea. We have enough of it from our mine, or our copper mine, or iron mine. It's really collapsy around here. Like we're making a dusty mess for some reason. Oh, starting to subside the crashiness. Wish it was all sand. Easier to move. The gravel's kind of annoying. I'd also like to have the top, like, only a ladder accessible, so things aren't hanging out up there. Oh, it's a little dark when we come around this side. Alright, let me grab that lantern again. Yeah, that is a lot of gravel. Jeepers. A lot of gravel. Yeah, if we need a, like, yeah, this will be fine. This 3x3 right here. I'll take these pieces out. I'll chomp this down. Oh, hi, that has to be not like that. This. And then we'll dig right down here to make a hole in the ground. Oh, chert underneath, okay. Clean up the front. Oh my goodness, look how much we collapsed out here. At least it didn't destroy anything. I don't think falling sand can actually, like, I think it just stops on an object instead of destroys the object. I've even seen it hit torches and stop, so we're just stuck on a wall. Right, and then we're probably going to use the space on the other side of this. Probably going to cut it down to flat, even if it's full of stone, to set up a decent smithing area in the future. I should also get, I mean, I could also get some of this quartz, but I don't really need it. Thick durability, not needed to be wasted, I suppose. Hey, decently clean soil. But I got all that earlier. Apparently not. All right, let's see what the bare bones of this is. I'll have to adjust the front area here a little. I think I'll take these three out. And let's say we have our entrance right in here. And we'll cut these out as well. It doesn't have to be like focused on being a specific amount of weatherproofing or anything like that. I could make it a double door. I could do that. No, we're gonna cut it down to symmetry for a single door. We'll go in like this. Convenient. And we'll leave that top one up, take this off. I might chisel some things down later. There we go, and this one. Nice. And I'll take that off. And it's nice and symmetrical. Beautiful. Okay. That. All the gravel. Okay. And this side is... Oh, look at that. That is very, very quaint. Fits nicely. It's probably not going to fit that nicely all the way around, but we'll see. I'll take a bit off the back here. Oh, beautiful red sky. I'd like better symmetry here. Suppose I don't care about the symmetry on that point, do I? Take these off. Look at this beautiful world of ours, huh? In the snowy chill. That's three. We need that one off. There we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Two, three, four, five, gone, gone, gone. Lovely. Carving up our own Mount Rushmore. Okay, then I need to go down in like this. Well, not this, but inside. Boom, right there. And clean up. Oh my goodness. Chunks of goodies everywhere. We'll take this off the side. We might, like, I'm thinking either we keep that for another windmill, or we turn this and turn this area into a smithy. Something like that, maybe. And we could build a bakery in here. Or kitchens and whatnot. Eventually. Look at me talking the future. Talking future plans. So how many, I guess I can go down until I hit, well, what we can do is we can hit Control V and we can see the middle number is the elevation. Boop, 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 boop. See, that middle number is the elevation. So what I want to do is want to be up here. Hold on. Clean up the back later, another date, but properly, but for now, get rid of this. Lovely. Okay. I'll go in here. Wait, I need to check what our floor or entry was. So here we're standing at 110. So we need to have 112. Well, we need to go down to a standing at 110. So. Boop. Now, apparently that hurt. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. Bingo! Into the good indoors. Okay, so this could collapse if we're not smart. So let's make some support structures. We'll use birch. I don't know if it makes a difference color-wise. I think it actually does, however. Let's take two of those. And we're going to make a bunch of birch into stripped stuff. So we need a hammer. Need a hammer and a chisel. Chisel there, if I remember correctly. Oh, is it axe and chisel? Axe and hammer? It's axe and hammer, not chisel. Like that, and this. Yeah, there we go. Debarked birch logs. Boom. And boom. Nice. And then, what is it? Saw to make those, I think. I think it is a saw to make them into the support beams. Yep, there we go. Boom. And boom. So three per piece. Yeah. We got six times the number. Yeah, so we got 32, 32, and 32 for support beams. Okay. That makes the sense. I'll leave that behind. We will leave that in its spot. The chisel can go in here for now. Hammer can go actually in here. This is supposed to be over there. The other saw can go away. Lovely. Now we've got support beams. So beautiful, bright, sunshiny day. What I'm going to do first, before we do that, is we're gonna clean out this thing. So size-wise, we only have this wall to the right, so we can't cut into that wall at all. And then we end with only three central wall pieces. So if we dig any further, we're going to cause grief. I'd like to do is put supports this way, then dig that out. Maybe? There is honey in here, isn't there? Okay. Let's clean out some stuff here. Can't put the support beam in when there's stuff is in here. 50% collapse chance? That's terrible. Let's put a support beam in there. And there. And there. Please don't collapse anything on me. That'd be horrible. Then I think how this works is that if we put in a beam in this level, it supports the upper level above it. I think that's what happens there. I could be wrong, but I'm under that impression. So we could do just horizontal beams across in this place. That'd be nice. Yeah, see, that's got a 50% collapse chance. How do I support that without collapsing it? That is also like super chance of collapse. I don't like that at all. Like this for now. I can take them out after. Oh, instability zero. Oh, hold on. Did I 16. Did I put them too low? Yeah, see, that was 50, wasn't it? Now it's zero. Oh. And then what? I put another one above it. Crisscross them. Beautiful. I like that. We have to hit the spot where it was attached to remove it. We get them all back. But we have to hit the spot where it's attached. Okay, if I do that, then how are these guys for support? Instability 0, 16%. Okay. We know that's extremely low chance of collapse. So I would like... I think we'll do the beam like that, and then cross beams in the back there as well. We got four rows. Can I line that out? There. Ow! Dang it! Seriously? Oh, that was a sadness and mistake. How did I get that there? Alright. So now our food thing is open. Darn it! Alright, we'll expand on its stability then. The construction materials over here. Didn't realize that was a gravel access point. That is concerning. But let's go close it up over here. Where did that fall through? Oh, back here. Oh, and that's sand as well. Well, that's not good at all. See? Not good at all, at all. Let's put in this, 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 and that. Oops, there. That should suffice for this one. Let's see if we can clean up the mess we just dug in here, buried in here. Now that is a rock, so... There and there. But I want this out without a collapse. Want this out without a collapse. So I go two walls in there. I'm going to put in a beam there to there to support that rooftop. Now it's mostly supported. Right? And then if I clear... Oh, that's further than I planned to clear? Oh, it is. That's what I did wrong. I did my numbers and counted, but I dug too deeply. Well, we're there now, so... that has to come off. Now, we could dig... We could put it in... here. No, instability is 50% there. Really? Okay. How about we do this then? Again, top middle there to top middle there. Those cross in nicely. I like that. I'm going to leave this obsidian right there. I'm going to totally leave that in place. All right, so I should be able to take these out without a collapse. It says 50%, but I don't think the ones above it should be. No, they're not highly collapsible. Okay. Well, not as anticipated. We'll need to move the honey bucket. But that's generally, as I understand it, how those work. So I think that's how those work. We'll put that down there. Put our honey bucket in the very back here. Put that away. Nice. Our bread making stuff there. We're gonna need another vessel and we're gonna need some more shelves. We'll put another three shelves up there. I don't think we can have shelves in here. Let's check. I don't know if shelves can be laid into that location. No, so it does need to have the open space. That's fine. So we'll get three in there, one in there. Not bad. We need four new shelf units. How are we doing? We're over an hour. Okay, we need to put in a cut here because, you know, that's how I roll. 1, 2, 3, and 4 shelving pieces. Good. Like that. You know what I could do? I could make one instead of the vessel in the bottom. I'm going to put grain in the bottom. And we'll bring all that grain chest in here. So this can be our grain storage. And then we can have the more space for more of that sort of stuff. That works fine for me. We will indeed need like... another barrel and whatnot for other reasons, but let's grab a small light like that, and we'll put a bit of animal fat in that light from here. One of those and a bowl. We've got ourselves a lamp, and we could just place it right there. I love lamp. So that is just a tiny little light in the area. So if I shut off my light, close the door, it's lit. Right, it's a little bit of little bit of glow. Oh, that is daylight bright in here, apparently. There's not much difference, if any. Might have even gotten darker. Preparing those like that. So, whatever. This is our jams. So, let's move our jams up to the top. Like that. Excellent. And this is our stews. More on a central level. .15 for vegetables, grain, and other. .19. Okay. I like it. Now, we also have a gazillion chunks of this. So, let's find out where all this should go. In our basalt storage. Stinking large amounts of it is what it is. We can make a bunch of, cobblestone out of the rocks that come out of it, but there's absolutely nothing I can think of to use for the gravel other than terraforming on flat bottom layers. So if we were to, if we wanted to elevate this by three, you know, we could do that with dirt. If we wanted to expand our farm out more towards that area, we could do another, we could do another layer of like in here, we could put, fill that stuff up with the sand and the gravel, and that would be good for more gardening. Oh yeah, for the record, that's where I got the branches from. See, how those just poles of bare tree, it's terrible. Yeah, okay, well that's enough materials for that. I think we should move our building braces in here. And put the rest of the stuff away and come back with you in the next episode, and we'll continue work on our windmill. This foundation will work nicely. I think if we do the actual windmill in granite cobble, that'll be nice. Granite blocks, granite cobble, whatever, up here. I think that'll be cool. We'll see what we can make form out of that and what kind of visuals I can make with it. I'll give it some thought in between episodes, and hopefully we can come up with something fun together. Thanks everybody so much for joining me. Hope you had yourselves a great rest of the day. See you in game.